And we're back. In this video, I'm going to tell you a lot more details about the structures, different stelae, and a little bit more secrets about Copan. And look at this. This is a maquette, an overview of what I'm about to show you and explain to you. Here we have the plaza, the ballcourt, then we have the stairway of the glyph that I will explain to you. And then over here we have the gigantic acropolis, and I'm going to tell you about temple 16, where there's seven different layers and temples underneath. And then it goes far that way. An extra will go the other side, back there. It doesn't exist in the maquette. Here you have it, the biggest glyph in all the Maya kingdom, the Stairway of Copan. 2,500 glyphs arranged together to tell a story, to keep in time the different king that ruled over Copan. 12 meters high, 63 steps in total, and 9 meters wide. Those 2,500 glyphs tells us about the different king that made Copan such a great Maya capital. It tells us about the ascension to the throne and then the death of that king. For example, the king number 12, Kak'utiwitzkawil, that ruled Copan from 628 to 695 AD. Archaeologists believe that he is the one who had the idea to build that gigantic glyph and to tell the story of Copan, actually, because the construction is estimated to be around 706 to 756 AD. It is said that this gigantic stairway was built in two phases by two different hands. From all my research, I couldn't find anything saying that there were more than two hands implicated in the construction and the sculpting of all those glyphs. It was built in two phases, like I said, and the king number 12 is mentioned in the two phases. Then we have king number 13, Waxaklahun Hubakawil, who ruled Copan from 695 to 738 AD. The 14th king, Kahak Hoplaj Chankawil, who ruled from 738 to 749 AD. Then we also have information about the 15th king, Kahak Yipyach Chankawil, who ruled Copan from 749 to 761, and then the final king, the 16th king, Yaxpasa, from 791 to 820. So the stairway is an actual timekeeping, king-keeping book to understand who ruled Copan over all those years.
Sí. Wow.
Y aquel es la parte final donde el sol llega. Luego empieza a regresar. En septiembre vuelve a pasar por aquí. En septiembre.
Septiembre.
Regresa allá para el 3 de febrero. Entonces, este es el ángulo solar del principio al fin del
sí.
Ángulo solar.
Wow.
Y lo mismo es a este lado. Principio y fin del solar. Sistema solar.
Ok, es 3 de febrero,
ahí.
21
de marzo, ahí.
Sí, sí. 21,
entre el 28 de abril y 3 de mayo aquí,
ok,
y luego en junio allá.
Wow. Uf, más conocimiento, sí. Gracias.
the beautiful Temple 16, found in the east side of the complex, 100 feet high. On top, you see the overall layout of all the complex. And this temple hides 6 different temples underneath. The earliest structure, the first one at the base of this temple, was built in the 5th century and was a palace and a tomb for the founder, Kinix Yaxkutmo. And the most wonderful discovery that archaeologists made under Temple 16 is named Rosalila. They called it Rosalila because of the color. It's a temple or a palace that was so beautiful. The art on this complex, on this palace, was so advanced and needed so much stucco that it's the last of its kind in all the Maya era and the Maya kingdom, because it needed too much stucco. And then we can also find Oro Pendola, which is another one. Both were buried after 650 AD. Rosalila's dimension are 18.5 meter by 12 meter at the base by 14 meters high. It has 3 level. It was the principal religious sanctuary at Copan in late 6th century. Unlike other building archaeologists found, Rosalila was perfectly, carefully buried. Rooms, molding, and niche were carefully filled with mud and stone, and the wonderful elaborated stucco panels were covered with a thick white plaster. The archaeologist that found it was from Honduras. His name is Ricardo Argurcia Fasquel. In 1989, he discovered it, and he discovered at the same time ceramic incense burner with charcoal inside, flint knives for sacrifice, 9 elaborate ceremonial scepters, carved jade jewelry wrapped in a deep blue cloth, conch shell, stingray spine, shark vertebrae, jaguar's claws, remains of flowers petals, and pine's needles.
This is quite big. How did they move this? Brought it up here and built beautiful stairs with it. How? Enjoy, because I'm not supposed to be here.
Ah, le va a tomar una foto ahí. Ah, ¿dónde va? Le va a tomar una foto aquí. Una foto, ¿sabes? Déjale. Ah, bueno, esto es donde vamos nosotros prácticamente por el cielo. Porque la parte de la plaza abajo allá es el cielo.
The tomb of the ultimate king ruling over here in Copan se llama Yaxpasa. altar queue is a really important altar. It shows the first king handing over the scepter, which is a stick of the ruler, passing it to the last king. And you can see all around this altar, from the first king to the last king, Yaxpasa, the 16th king. You can count them. You will count 16. And then once we get back to the front, you will see Yaxpasa receiving the stick, the scepter from the founder, Kinix Yaxkumo, who founded COPAN in 426 AD. So this altar was actually built by Yaxpasa, the last king, to commemorate all the other kings before him.
Original, pues pasa en el museo, la van a ver ahí. Como el altar que se llama allá, donde están todos los reyes. Un enfoque también. Todo lo que vimos allá.
so many details. So beautiful.
Y está sosteniendo siempre la serpiente. El penacho era de plumas de cerro y papagayo. Y la figurita que aparece aquí es el dios del maíz. ¿Sí? A ambos lados aparece la figura del dios del maíz. Entonces aquí es este rey y ese rey.
In the next video, what you'll have is a secret area where the elite was living. It's 1 kilometer away from here. They say it's closed, but if you know me, nothing is closed when it's in the nature. So I'll try to get in. right here behind me, they found the remains of a 12-year-old boy with lots of precious gifts, like flutes, like ceramics. So it's pretty intriguing because usually such a young age don't get a gift in their burials. But this guy, this 12-year-old guy, was probably the kid of a ruler, and he was put in the ground with lots of gifts, lots of precious items.
No le pueden dar de comer.
No, solamente
le dimos semillas. ¿Solo
semillas? Buen día, bienvenidos. Pasen adelante. Tenemos agua y refresco, jóvenes.
Okay, we're done with the visit of Copan. Now it's time to go to Quirigua with this beat. Follow me. Let's go.